Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. In this video, we're going to take a planetary camera, the ZWO ASI 224MC, and see if we can take deep sky images. Now, this camera has been around for about 5 years. It costs around £200 in the UK, and it's known as being a low noise, high sensitivity camera. But it says on the box that it's a planetary camera. So shouldn't we really just be using it for taking pictures of Jupiter and Mars? Well, let's see if it can turn its hand to deep sky objects. So instead of looking through a Maxitov, which is the kind of telescope I normally use with one of these cameras, I'm going to connect it to my William Optics GT81, which is normally my deep sky imaging telescope that I use with a digital SLR. But this time we're going to mix things up and see if we can get any decent deep sky results with this camera that is still advertised as being for planets. Okay, so here's the setup. We've got the GT81 sitting on my HEQ5 Pro, and here's the camera. I've used a 2-inch photo adapter, which I've put the 224 into the end of that, and obviously I'm going to use lots of cables, so let's see how we get on. Okay, so we're looking at Firecapture and the scope is pointing at Messier 81, one of the brighter galaxies you're going to find high in the sky in Ursa Major. So I'm using a 10 second exposure in Firecapture, and I've used the dark frame setting as well to try and subtract a bit of noise that may be coming from the camera. And this is what we're seeing. So this is a frame clocking along every 10 seconds. Now I'm also using a guide camera today because I want to make sure that the galaxy stays in the center of the frame. So I've got PhD guiding set up as well, trying to help us out, trying to keep the images aligned with these long 10 second exposures. So it's going to take, I don't know, couple hundred, see how long the setup hangs together, and then we'll stack it all together and see how the result looks. So after taking the frames through Deep Sky Stacker and playing around a little bit with the levels and curves, then this is the result. So it's captured the spiral structure of the galaxy quite well. It is pretty noisy, and I've tried this target a few times, playing around with different gain settings and exposures, and each time I've got a little bit more noise than I'd like. But probably if I put 200 or 300 frames into it, I'll get a better definition. But overall, not too bad. So now I've moved the telescope slightly to the south to look at Hercules. And this is Messier 13, the Great Globular Cluster. Now it's pretty low in the sky for me. It's about maybe 15 or 20 degrees above the horizon. And after a bit of playing around finding the object, which is not that easy considering it's quite a small field of view with this camera, I've got it centralized and I'm now taking, again, 10 second exposures. Something shot through the frame there, not sure what that was. I'm taking 10 second exposures, got the gain set at just under 400. It's a little bit trial and error, and well, we'll see how these come out. So after Deep Sky Stacker, this is the result. Taking 60 frames and not really doing a great deal to it. I think it's recorded the object really well. Good contrast, quite a refractor-like view, and perhaps what you should expect using this camera on a small but bright deep sky object. So a good result. After that, I moved to a planetary nebula. This is the Owl Nebula, Messier 97. And I moved towards using longer exposures, 20 seconds this time, and slightly lower gain. So I think it's recorded the nebula pretty well. You can see the eyes of the owl. There's a little bit of sort of leaching of light somehow at the lower right, but it's not. It doesn't distract from a pretty nice image, given that it's quite a short amount of total time on the target. And then finally, returned back close to M81, and now looked at its companion, Messier 82, and it records well. It's much a smaller object than 81, and always records in less time when I've imaged it previously. And this is 70 odd 20 second frames and captures quite a bit of detail,
and some colour as well in the central part of the galaxy. So yeah, again, pretty suited to use with the ASI 224MC. So what have we learned? Well, basically my experiment shows that this camera, the ZWO ASI 224MC, is definitely more than just a planetary camera. You can get good images of small deep sky objects that fit within its limited field of view. And I recommend, if you've got one of these and you're just looking at planets at the moment, maybe give it a try on some other targets. Some specifics, for me, I found that the camera works with longer exposures of maybe 20 or 30 seconds and slightly lower gain. I'm using around 250, rather than where I started off, which was using 10 second or lower exposures and a much higher gain setting. By going for longer exposures at less gain, then I think overall the stacked image will get a better histogram. It's slightly easier to pull out the data and reduce the noise. So definitely the noise, the sensitivity and the read noise is such that you can get much, much longer exposures than you might think are going to work out with a planetary camera. Other than that, I started off unguided, and basically that showed that my polar alignment was not spot on, and that resulted in some walking noise. So that is it. When I stacked together the images, there'd been a bit of drift of the target, and the stacked image had sort of trailed lines of RGB light, which really didn't look too good in terms of noise. So I went to use guiding, and that obviously keeps the object centralized, but that in itself showed up a problem. So I discovered that if you're using two ZWO cameras with PhD guiding, so I had one imaging on Firecapture, the other one for guiding, then PhD2 can try and grab control of the wrong camera. So there's a setting in PhD2 to tell it which of your ZWO cameras you're trying to use, just as there is a setting when you power up Firecapture when there are two of these cameras connected. So lesson learnt, obviously that was a night loss where I couldn't figure out under the stars how to get the guiding working, but well, that's Astro. Okay, so I think, yeah, give it a go. 224MC, good camera. I hope this has been a useful video. If you haven't yet subscribed to Jenham's Astro, then please click the button, and hopefully I'll be producing some more videos using this camera in the near future, both deep sky and obviously planetary, like it says on the box. Okay, thanks for watching.